Let me start by saying that I wholeheartedly believe that Donald Trump is a horrible human being, and if he were to be elected, he would be the worst president that the United States has ever seen. Having said that, I have to admit a very sad truth, and that is that Donald Trump is absolutely remaking American politics for the better. Think about it this way. Donald Trump's candidacy has proven what we've been talking about for years, that the Republican Party is filled with racist, xenophobic woman haters. There would be incidences here and there a few times a year to reinforce these theories, but you'd always have some more prominent, mature Republican leader who would come out and say that this wasn't what the party stood for. They don't have that today, and that's a great thing for politics, because it removes all doubt about what the Republican Party of today actually stands for. Sarah Palin actually said something last week that was quite interesting regarding Trump's rise to prominence within the party. Take a look.
I am so happy that he is running. Here's the deal, Greta. I think with Donald Trump, he's the best thing to happen to the permanent political class since, oh, I guess the beauty of the Tea Party genuine movement rose up and shined light on crony capitalism and then pulled the rug right out from under status quo politicians who just, you know, kind of embraced that permanent political class. Donald Trump, he's got these Joe six-pack issues on his mind, and he's got these Joe six-pack common sense solutions. He just happens to be an extremely successful and charismatic, with a very large platform, Joe Sixpack. But amazing how it is that he is connecting with the people, and what it is that we've been saying all along. Finally, we have someone with the guts who isn't bought by anyone. He doesn't belong to anyone. He's his own man. He's very independent. So I'm very pleased that he is offering himself up in the name of service to our country.
Donald Trump sounds like your typical drunk uncle who has a few too many at Thanksgiving dinner and rambles on and on about how the government is the root of all evil in this country. And conservatives, like Sarah Palin, absolutely love that about him because he is just as dumb as they are. Trump has shown us how far to the right the Republicans have really shifted in recent years. He's showing us that they are a party with absolutely no ideas, and when they do announce some form of policy, it's always either anti-immigrant, anti-African-American, anti-woman, anti-elderly, or anti-consumer. I cannot think of a single Republican policy proposal in recent years that would have actually helped the American public as a whole. Donald Trump is destroying the Republican Party by doing nothing more than showing the public what that party actually represents, what they actually believe. Trump is not the cause of the party's shift. He's the end result. He's managed to force every other GOP presidential candidate to either adopt his extremist positions or to fade into obscurity. The base is energized over Donald Trump, and that's why he's still climbing in the polls. And if he keeps it up, the Republican Party is absolutely doomed. Pandering to the base of the party, which is also now the fringe of the party, will absolutely get you to victory in the primaries. But no political party can win a national election with only the base. There are just not enough voters in those blocks to do that. So you have to have Hispanics, you have to have African Americans, you have to have women, the elderly, and youth voters in your camp if you want to move into the White House. And Trump is working on alienating every single one of those groups simply by embracing what his party actually stands for. And that's why Donald Trump is the best possible thing to happen to American politics. He's destroying the Republican Party by exposing them, and there isn't a single thing that they can do about it.